They don't dispute. In fact, it's amazing for people who, someone who writes as much controversial stuff as I do, I get remarkably little criticism. I get denunciations, I get name calling, and the ones who are really smart simply say nothing and pretend that I haven't said anything, and they go on.
I am American.
Why have so many so-called civil rights and black leaders rejected? I mean, you know how much they dislike you. Why?
Well, why does the mafia dislike policemen? I mean, they're making their racket harder. You know, that if people believe what I say, then of course they're not going to believe what these people say. These people have a huge investment in this. I mean, money and all the rest of power, the rest of it.
I think you've written that for the civil rights movement, emphasizing civil rights is the thing that will help blacks and other poor people the most is a distraction. It won't.
That's right. If you look at the data, you find that blacks were rising faster prior to the civil rights movement and since the civil rights movement. For all kinds of reasons, blacks were getting more education, they're getting a better quality of education in a different part of the country and so forth.
Mm-hmm. Well, you got in just in time.
Yeah, I'm lucky as can be in that respect.
What has affirmative action achieved here and anywhere?
What it's achieved generally has been to give benefits to a group of people who are already more fortunate. Whereas if you're a black millionaire, affirmative action is great because you get to buy radio stations at a lower cost and so forth. This is not many people in the middle of the ghetto are going to be looking to go to Harvard Law School or to buy a radio station. There's no evidence whatever that people who are poor, either here or in any other country which I've studied, have actually benefited from this. It's almost all the benefits have gone to those who are already more fortunate beforehand.
You got into Harvard as a transfer student. Have you ever been a beneficiary of affirmative action, do you think?
You know, one of the many pieces of good fortune is that I was born before, I'm so old, I was born before all these programs came in. So I don't even have to worry about these things. I entered Harvard in 1955. Affirmative action started around 1970. So I don't, you know, my academic career began in 1962, which is 2 years before the Civil Rights Act of 64. Mm-hmm. And so but the younger blacks, it's a heavy weight for some of them.
Why?
They don't know, how will they know whether they were hired because they were the best person or because they were black? The people who are playing the race card at every turn, because the people who are hurt most by that are the blacks themselves. You know, if years ago when I was giving a talk at Marquette, a young black man got up and he said, "I'm about to graduate from Marquette University, but what hope is there for me?" And I said, "There's about twice as much hope as there was for your parents and 10 times what there was for your grandparents." But he has been convinced that he can't make it.
Married, with a grown son of his own who didn't talk until he was nearly 4 years old, Thomas Sowell knows the importance of not giving up.
We knew there was going to be barriers. We would just keep going over them, through them, around them, or whatever. But now you've raised a whole generation of people who think it's absolutely hopeless.
Who's telling them that?
Oh, Jesse Jackson, Al Sharpton, you can run through the whole list of them.
Mm-hmm. But it can't all be just blacks.
No, there are all sorts of whites who are saying the same thing, you know, that every statistical disparity is proof that there are these huge barriers out there.
What should the civil rights movement be for now?
Dissolution. They've won, declare victory, go home and start putting your efforts into something else like education, entrepreneurship, all kinds of other things that have a much bigger payoff.
Why don't they do that?
Because they're specialized. I mean, you know, how come our wrestlers don't go in for violin playing? Mm-hmm. Well, they don't have those skills.
I mean, there's nothing else Jesse Jackson can do.
Well, do you think Jesse Jackson can become a violinist?
I don't. Al Sharpton?
Not bloody likely.